So knowing that this is clear, I push my little ball down. I've blown air through it. Is it just my wonderful grease gun?
We'll resurrect the air gun.
Okay. That's why I leave me no choice. I can either sit here and fiddle with every one of these, or I can just pull them out, throw them all in the bottom of a can of acetone, and wait until tomorrow. But I think that's what I'm gonna do. Yeah, I could go around and I could just go ahead and pump. Wait and see which one is which. Which one takes grease, which one doesn't. Or I can just make sure they all take grease before I even start. I don't have enough grease to waste by pumping half of it out on the ground. So I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, it's tomorrow. All my zerks have been in this can. About an inch of lacquer thinner in here. Something I got at an auction. Might as well put it to good use. It's like playing the lottery. I removed all the zerks from the stems. That would come out anyway. No, I'm not gonna make you watch me pull all of them out of the can. Well, there ain't much of a hole for it to go through there. I wonder.
Encrusted.
Oh yeah. So three of them are still plugged. Back in the can they go. Leave them set here while I install the rest. Well, okay, all the grease zerks are in. I haven't put the gun to them. I just found something else.
Whilst putting the chain back on, I noticed this idler is out of kilter with the rest of the chain. Then I noticed the mouth for the idler is quite askewed. So whatever they did to mangle that housing, the shield, they managed to mangle that too.
Have I missed any? Yes, one. Might as well put the drain plug in while I'm here. I think what I should like to do now is remove all the interfering tines. Well, not remove them, but repair everything that's interfering. Okay. Great. Oh, I see why.
So I see this bracket here received a little smashola in its life.
that's bent a little bit in right there. This is bent a little bit here. And now to move it away. There. Can't really get a swing on it though, and I really hate swinging toward myself. Never turns out good. Left-handed. Oh. I don't think I did a thing. Yeah, this is bent. Well, I have another way to fix it. But I have to hook it up to the tractor first. So we'll get to that later. Otherwise, nothing else is interfering. Extended drop bar. Bolt was missing because the teeth are missing, the rake tines are missing off of there. They just had that bolt through there, which was not tight, so this is allowed to rock back and forth. Then I find on another one, it's allowed to do the same thing. Not enough. I don't know if I have a bolt to go through there or not. I'll have to see if I can find one. Okay. Hayfield Follies continues. Now that I'm done with this, I gotta go park this and go get more. So we'll see you next time.
Okay, new tip.
Okay, the used tip. It still gushes out the side.
Of course, there's also this brace here too. And that, the wheel's bent over that way. The brace on the back is going the other way. I'm gonna start here. Worry about the rest later.
How much more grease shall I waste? I don't have any grease guns left.
Well, while you were gone unloading the camera, there's this sliding track on this cover. Put this on. I couldn't get that on there. That wouldn't slide back far enough.
I had to whack and hack that off of there, this mint and bangled thing.
That's gone. And I had it running. It went in the opposite direction, but I figured out what that was about.
First one was better.